गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. आई एम प्रतीक्षा भालेराव फ्रॉम टैंक रोड एमपीएस सेकेंडरी स्कूल भांडुप एंड वी हैव बीन लर्निंग एन लेसन दैट इज लाइफ प्रोसेसेस इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. एंड टुडे इज आवर फोर्थ सेशन. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर थ्री सेशन प्रीवियसली एंड डन विद द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स, एक्सक्रीशन इन प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स एंड ह्यूमंस एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन इन प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स. ओके, सो नाउ कोऑर्डिनेशन. What we have learned about coordination in plants, growth relevant movements, coordination in human beings, nervous control, neurons we have learned. Okay, so let us rewind something that we have learned on the last session, the third session, that coordination in human beings. Okay, so different processes go simultaneously in human body. Okay, so the process need to be efficient and effectively controlled and coordinated, otherwise it will disturb our system. So for this, to do the work well, we need to take the help of two systems. One is nervous control and so nervous control. Humans can respond to changes in their surroundings due to nervous control, and impulses are generated in human body. In accordance with changes in surrounding, nervous control plays the important role of empowering the body cells with ability to respond to these impulses. So this impulse, the ability depends upon the complexity of organization and the organism's body structure. So it works like that. So we have learned about neuron also. It's a special type of cell which can control and coordinate in our brain. So nerve cell also called as neurons. So what are neurons? Special types of cells which conduct impulse from one place to another in body are called neurons. So neurons are structural and functional unit of nervous system, and the nerve cell, it is the largest cell in the human world. It measures up to few meters in length also. So the nerve cells have ability to generate and conduct electrochemical impulses. The cells that support the nerve cells and help in their functioning are called neuroglia. So these nerve cells and neuroglial cells together form the nerves. And the information about our surroundings is collected by the and or dendrites of the neuron. So the chemical process begins at those ends, and electric impulses are generated, which are conducted from the dendrites to the cell body, from the cell body to the axon, and from axon to its terminal. So likewise, this will happen, and the chemical pass through a minute space called synapse also. So between two adjacent neurons and generate the impulse in the dendrites of next neuron. In this way, impulses are conducted in the waves in the body, and these impulses are finally conveyed by nerve cells to muscle cells or glands. We have learned till this also. Okay, so now what we are going to learn are today is type of nerve cells and human nervous system. In that, central nervous system, brain and spinal cord, peripheral nervous system, and autonomic nervous system. So the type, let us start with the types of nervous system. According to their function, nerve cells are classified into three types. We have learned about nerve cell. What is nerve cell? It is a structural and functional unit of nervous system. Okay, so these are the neurons or nerve cells. And again, nerve cells are of three types: sensory neuron, motor neuron, and association neuron. Means nerve cells. So according to their function, nerve cells are classified according to the function, how they work inside our nervous system. According to that, they are classified into sensory neurons, motor neurons, association neurons. In sensory neurons conduct impulse from sensory organs to the brain and spinal cord. See, senses, convey the senses also. So the sensory neurons conduct impulse from sensory organs to the brain and spinal cord. From the impulse, it sends the impulse. Okay, so from to brain and spinal cord. So we will get the message on something is going to be happen. So it will get alert. Okay, now the motor neuron. So motor neuron conduct impulse from the brain and spinal cord to effector organs like muscles or glands. Again, see. In sensory neurons, it conducts impulse from sensory organs. Whatever sensory organs we have, sensory organs, right? Sense organs we have. So, eyes, nose, है ना, आईज, नोज, ईयर, स्किन एंड टंग, अदर सेंसरी ऑर्गन्स. ओके, सो इट इम्पल्स सेंसरी सेंसेस फ्रॉम सेंसरी ऑर्गन टू द ब्रेन, लाइक समथिंग is going to be happen. And motor neuron, what is the work of the motor neuron? Motor neuron conduct impulse from the brain and spinal cord to effector organs like muscle or gland. It again make an effect and send a message that something is going to be happen. And association neurons. Association neurons perform the function of integration in between the nervous system. It associates it. And it works likewise. So sensory neurons, motor neurons, and association neurons together functions well for our nervous system. So you can see three pictures are shown, and these are the diagrammatic representations of motor neuron. Motor neuron, the second one, which conduct impulse from the brain and spinal cord to effector organs like muscles or glands. Okay, so these are the motor neurons. You can see picture. It is elongated structure. The orange color part is there, which is the cell body. Dark brown color portion is the nucleus, and the purple color elongated body is its node of Ranvier, and the last one is the yellowish color is the axon or terminal. So in the three pictures, all the three pictures, the same things are there, but the structure is little bit different. Motor neuron is as simple. Interneuron means the nervous system is in between, maybe, and in the sensory it is again in between, and at the end axon terminals are there. So likewise this happens. So this work, the sensory neurons conduct impulse from the body. Suppose we are going to be burned. Some heat, something is heated, boiled water is kept somewhere, and we suddenly we touch it. What will happen? It touches to our skin. The skin sends impulse from this skin to brain. It is hot. So brain and spinal cord get the message, and again they send the impulse to others as, okay, we need to remove your hand. You need to remove your hand, otherwise you will get hurt. So this type of functions helps inside the nervous system, and our body is working properly. So these three nerve cells are there, which are classified according to their functions, like sensory neurons, motor neurons, and association neurons. Now the human nervous system. How the human? You can see the picture is there. Inside that you can see central nervous system is shown. Peripheral nervous system is also shown. Okay. So in central nervous system you can see that brain and spinal cord is given. And in peripheral ganglion and nerves are shown. So our human nervous system is based on it only, and it is divided into the three parts. Central nervous system, which is in short called as CNS, peripheral nervous system, in short it is called as PNS, autonomous nervous system, in short it is called as ANS. Okay, so these are the three types of human nervous system inside the body: central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, and autonomic nervous system. Now the central nervous system. Let's start with the central nervous system. The central nervous system consists of brain and spinal cord. You can see a picture is given in front of you. In that, brain is shown and the yellow portion is there. So the upper part, the reddish part, is brain, and the yellow elongated structure is called a spinal cord, which goes at the back. Okay, so this is the central nervous system, which consists of brain and spinal. So we can togetherly call this, the structure of brain and spinal cord togetherly called as CNS, means central nervous system. So the organization of brain is extremely delicate and highly evolved. It is highly evolved, means all of our body structure, whatever the function, the movements and all the activities are done only with the help of this nervous system, with the help of the brain. So it is very highly evolved in function, and it is very much delicate. It is very much delicate one. Okay. So the brain is the main controlling part of the nervous system. It is the main controlling part of the nervous system, and it is safely located in the cranial cavity. Very safely located in the cranial cavity. cranial cavity. So it is based on the it is there in the cranial, located in the cranial cavity. So it controls the nervous system. It controls our nervous system all over. So we can understood that in central nervous system, brain and spinal cord is there. Brain is very much extremely delicate and highly evolved structure, and it is the main controlling part of the nervous system, and it is safely located in the cranial cavity. The cavity in between where the brain is held, it is called as cranial cavity. The spinal cord is protected by vertebral column. We can see that spinal cord is shown. So it is protected by vertebral column also. In the space between the delicate central nervous system and its bony covering are the protective layering called meninges. So we need, it needs to be safe, so some space is there in between the central nervous system and the bony structure, and it is a protective layer called as meninges. It is called as meninges. So the cavities present in various parts of the brain are called ventricles. The cavities whatever present in the brain are called ventricles. There is a long tubular cavity of spinal cord is called as central canal. It is called as central canal. So the ventricles, central canal, and spaces between the meninges are filled with cerebrospinal fluid. It is filled with cerebrospinal fluid. This fluid supplies nutrients to the central nervous system and protects it from the shock. It protects the central nervous system from the shock only. So we can understood that central nervous system of the consists of brain and spinal cord, and the organization of brain is extremely delicate and highly evolved, and all the functions are done with this only. And the brain is the main controlling part of the nervous system, and it is safely located in the cranial cavity. And the spinal cord protected by the vertebral column. So in the space between the delicate central nervous system and its bony covering are the protective layers called the meninges. The cavities present in the various parts of the brain are called ventricles, and the long tubular cavity of the spinal cord is called as central canal. The ventricle, central canal, and the spaces between the meninges are filled with the cerebrospinal fluid. This fluid supplies nutrients to the central nervous system and protects it from the shock. So now the structure of brain, let us learn about the structure of brain. The brain is made up of cerebrum, cerebellum, and medulla oblongata. Cerebrum, cerebellum, and medulla oblongata. So the brain of an adult human weighs about 1300 to 1400 grams and consists of approximately 100 billion neurons. See, we have learned about the neuron also. Neuron means nervous cells, which is the structure and functionality of nervous system. So neurons are classified into three types, according to their function: sensory neuron, motor neuron, and association neuron. And in that also, in the brain itself, 100 billion neurons. So see how many neurons are there inside the brain. So many are there. So 100 billion neurons are there, and each neuron functions differently. Each functions. These three types of neurons are there. So these three types of functions separately. So the brain is made up of three parts: cerebrum, cerebellum, and medulla oblongata. You can see in the picture, the yellowish portion is the cerebrum, cerebral hemisphere. Then the green color portion is cerebellum, and the purple color portion is medulla oblongata. You can see in the picture. So the brain structure is made up of cerebrum, cerebellum, and medulla oblongata. It weighs about, what is the weight of the brain? Is 1300 to 1400 grams. And it approximately consists of 100 billion neurons inside the brain. Now see, the left side of our brain controls the right side of the brain. See, it is always crossed. This, the right side brain controls the left portion, and the left side brain controls the right portion. So the left side of our brain controls the right side of the body, and the right side of our brain controls the left side of the body. It works like that. You can see in the picture, left and right parts are given. In the left part, analytical thinking, numbers, languages, reasoning, logic, and science and math included. And the right side, emotional intelligence, imagination, expression, art awareness, intuitions, and creativity is there. So the person whose right side is more active is good in all other art and art and creativity things, and the left portion portion is much active in that. That person is good in analytical thinking, numbers, and mathematics, languages, different types of languages, reasoning skill, logical thinking skill, and science and math. Okay, so so the left brain again, the bluish color portion is left brain in that logic, realistic in control, linear, analytical, scientific, accurate, practical, mathematics, categorized, and strategic. All these things help in left brain, and the right brain is free spirit, feeling, senses, art, creativity, poetry, yearning, sensuality, passion, imagination, and vivid things are happening. So these are the we can understood by that the left side of our brain controls the right, left side controls the right side, and the right side controls the left. So in addition, the left side of the brain controls our speech and conversation, writing, logical thinking, etc., whereas the right side controls artistic ability. So you can understood by the picture the how our left and right brain works, hai na. Now cerebrum is the largest part of our brain and consists of two cerebral hemispheres. It is the largest part and consists of two cerebral separate portions are there, left cerebral hemisphere and right cerebral hemisphere, which is the largest part of the brain. The part which is all consists, see in here in the picture, you can see the yellowish portion, hai na, the yellowish light color portion is there. This is the cerebellum. Okay, so it divides into two parts, left and right part. These hemispheres are joined with each other with the help of tough fibers and nerve tracts. Tough fibers and nerve tracts are there, and so it joins with the help of that only. So the cerebrum occupies 2/3 of the brain. It occupies 2/3 of the brain. 2/3 structure of the brain is occupied, and hence it is called as large brain. So due to that only, it is called as large brain. Its surface has deep irregular ridges and grooves, which are called as inconvolution. You can see that the black color portion is there. So these are the deep irregular ridges are there. Grooves are there, which are called convolutions, which are called as convolution. Convolution increases the surface area of the cerebrum, and therefore a large number of cells can be accommodated. Due to that only this convolution increases the surface area of the cerebrum. So see, it is the largest part of the brain, which consists of two cerebral hemispheres. And these hemispheres are joined with each other with the help of tough fibers and nerve tracts. It occupies 2/3 portion of the brain, hence it is called as large brain. So the red color portion is cerebrum. Convolution increases the surface area of the cerebrum, and therefore a large number of nerve cells are accommodated. Okay, so this is cerebrum. Now cerebellum. Here you can see the brown portion. You can see the line portions are there. Line portion is the cerebellum. So this is the smaller part of the brain, hai na? This is the smaller part of the brain situated below the cerebrum. It is situated below the cerebrum and at the back of the cranial cavity. Cranial cavity is there. It is at the back of it. So its surface shows shallow grooves instead of deep convolutions. See, in cerebrum, deep convolutions are there, but here in cerebellum, grooves are shallow. Shallow grooves are there. It means they are not that much deep. Now medulla oblongata. This is the hindmost part of the brain. Hindmost means at the back only it is there. It is present. So there are two triangular swollen structures called pyramids on the upper side of medulla oblongata. Triangular portion you can see over there, and these are called the upper side of medulla oblongata. The medulla oblongata continues downwards, and the spinal cord is there. See, you can see in the picture the upper portion cerebrum, then the smaller portion or cerebellum and the medulla oblongata you can see over here. So it elongated till the spinal cord. So this is the hindmost part. This is the two triangular swollen structures are there called as pyramids. So we can see that in cerebrum, it is the largest part. The part which is shown is like color pinkish part is there. This is the cerebrum, it is the largest part of our brain and consists of two cerebral hemispheres. These hemispheres are joined with each other with the help of tough fibers and nerve tracts, and the cerebrum occupies 2/3 of the brain. Hence, it is called as large brain. Its surface has deep irregular ridges and grooves which are called as convolutions. Convolution increases the surface area of the cerebrum, and therefore a large number of nerve cells can be accommodated. And in the cerebellum, this is the smaller part of the brain situated below the cerebrum and at the back of the cranial cavity. Its surface shows shallow grooves instead of deep convolution. Medulla oblongata in front of you, this is the hindmost part of the brain. There are two triangular swollen structures called pyramids on the upper side of the medulla oblongata. And the medulla oblongata continues downwards as the spinal cord. This is spinal cord. Spinal cord is a part of CNS. CNS means what? Central nervous system, which consists of brain and spinal cord. So spinal cord is a part of CNS, central nervous system, and it is held within the vertebral column. Vertebral column, you can see that the colorful columns are shown, means the spinal cord, these are the vertebral columns. It is slightly thick but gradually tapers down towards the end. See, it is gradually thick, but when we go down, you know, it towards the coccyx. So over there, it tapers down at the end. There is a fibrous structure at the ends, and it is called phylum terminal. It is called as phylum terminal. So this spinal cord is a part of central nervous system, and it is held within the vertebral column. And it is slightly thick, but gradually tapers to down towards the earth. There is a thread-like fibrous structure at the end. It's called as phylum terminal. You can see cleavers is there. Then cervical is there, purple color portion, cervical, the yellowish portion, thoracic. You have thoracic cage over there. In that spinal cord, vertebrae are there. Then the red or green portion, lumbar, furnace, medullar, cauda, inguinal, and discs are there. Then sacral, and then coccyx, blue color coccyx is there. So all these are the spinal cord. So the medulla oblongata grows till the spinal cord. So we have learned about the cerebrum, cerebellum, and medulla oblongata and the spinal cord. So spinal cord again is a part of central nervous system, and it is held within the vertebral column. It is slightly thick, but gradually tapers towards the end, and there is a thread-like fibrous structure at the end, and it is called as phylum terminal. Now, you can see a person is there, struggles to maintain his body, which drunks. Suppose a person is drunk, he has taken the alcohol. Okay, so what will happen sometimes he cannot maintain his body balance, and he is shivering and moving little bit. So an excess of alcohol in the body causes one of the loose control over it. Why does it happen? We need to find out the answer. Why does it happen? Because it disturbs the spinal cord, and it disturbs the brain only. The brain gets disturbed, so the nerves cannot send the messages properly, and due to this only, it will happen. Now, these are the parts of the brain and their functions. So, in the parts of the brain, cerebrum, we have learned the largest portion, you can see the cerebellum, medulla oblongata, and spinal cord. So, the cerebrum, once again, is the largest part of our brain. And it consists of two cerebral hemispheres. These hemispheres are joined with each other with the help of tough fibers and nerve tracts. The cerebrum occupies 2/3 part of the brain, and it is called as large brain. You can see the reddish most bigger portion is there, which are called as cerebrum. and its surface has deep irregular ridges and grooves which are called convolution. This convolution increases the surface area of the cerebrum, and therefore a large number of nerve cells can be accommodated due to, for this purpose only, convolutions are there which are deep, deeper than the cerebrum. Now the cerebrum, second, this is a smaller part of the brain situated below the cerebrum at the back of the cranial cavity. Its surface shows shallow grooves instead of deep convolution. Deep convolution. So these are the shallow grooves. Now medulla oblongata. This is the hindmost part of the brain. Brainstem, we can call it as brainstem also, and medulla oblongata also. And there are two triangular swollen structures called pyramids on the upper side of the medulla oblongata. So the medulla oblongata continues downwards as the spinal cord. So what the functions of cerebrum are, it control of the voluntary movement. Whatever voluntary movements are there, it controls that only. Then our concentration, planning, decision making, memory, intellectual activities, all are controlled by this cerebrum only. So the intelligence, learning, judgment, speech and memory, sense of hearing, vision, taste and smell, skeletal muscles, movements. All these are the functions of cerebrum. Then cerebellum balance and coordination. We have learned, discussed one example of the drunken person. Now, he has taken the alcohol in more amount. So what will happen if his body will does not balance? It is due to only this cerebellum only. So the cerebellum performs the function of balance and coordination in the body, and maintain the body's balance also. So medulla oblongata means brain step only. It control of involuntary activities, involuntary means which cannot be seen by the eyes. So the beating of heart, which is inside our body, beating of heart is there. So blood circulation, breathing, sneezing, coughing, salivation, all these are the activities that are controlled involuntary activities are controlled by medulla oblongata. Then spinal cord is there. Spinal cord means conduction of impulse from the skin towards the brain. So means we have learned about, we have discussed one example of the hot boiling water container is there. Suppose if we touch it by mistake, what will happen? Send the impulse towards the brain, and then the conduction of impulse from the, again the brain will send again the message to the skin or to remove the hand. So the functions as center of coordination of reflex action is here only. So this is cerebrum, which control of voluntary movement, concentration, planning, decision making, memory, intelligence and intellectual activities are there. Cerebellum, coordination of voluntary movements, maintaining the body's balance, control of involuntary activities like the beating of heart, blood circulation, breathing, sneezing, coughing and salivation. Spinal cord, conduction of impulses from the skin towards the brain, conduction of impulse from the brain to muscles and glands, functions as center of coordination of reflex action. So all these things are there. These are the functions in that. So let us rewind what we have learned from the first day. Okay, let us rewind in short, very much, very shortly we will rewind with all the things. So we have learned about transportation, like the by the process of transportation, a substance either synthesized or absorbed in one part of the body reaches to another is called as transportation. Transportation in plant is held by two conducting tissues, xylem and phloem. Xylem carries water and minerals from the roots and sends it to each and every part of the plant. Over there in leaves, which is called a food factory of plant, food is prepared, and the prepared food is again sent to each and every part by the conducting tissue, which is called as phloem, and it requires much energy to do this, and the ATP and the energy is obtained from ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Then excretion, we have learned excretion in plants and animals are also there. So excretion in plants is a simpler process than the excretion in animals. So in excretion in plants, what will happen? Plants store its extra material or excretory material inside the vacuole which is there present inside the plant cell, then flower, inside the flower, then inside the fruit and the bark of the stem. So all these four things are there which store the excretory material of the plant, and for when it ripens, the fruit get ripened, it will fall automatically, means the excretory material is fall out. Then the fruit, when we have flowers to pluck or flowers automatically fall down, means it is filled with the excretory material of the plants and it falls down. Same for the bark also, and for the vacuoles, when the season of autumn came, means in that what will happen, the all the leaves get yellow and it will fall down. And then again after some time, again in the spring season, it grows again and it looks very greenery. So like this only the plants get excretion. Then human excretory system is there. So there are different organ system for these excretory systems. Human excretory system consists of pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, a urinary bladder, and the urethra. So the urine is formed by the kidneys by separating the waste and unwanted excess substance from the blood. So the two bean-shaped dark color kidneys are situated on either side of the vertebral column of the posterior side of the abdomen. The functional unit of the kidney that performs the basic part, called as basic function of the filtration, is called as nephron. So each nephron has a cup-like thin-walled upper part called Bowman's capsule. In that, the network of capillaries in it called the glomerulus. The urea producing liver comes into the blood. When the urea containing blood comes into the glomerulus, it is filtered through its capillaries and urea and other similar substances also, and it gets separated. Some water molecules also get separated as it is a semi-permeable membrane of Bowman's capsule. Then likewise, it will go, then afterwards when the urine is formed from the remaining solution which is full of waste material, the urine is also carried by the ureters and stored in the urinary bladder. Afterwards, what will happen, urine is given out through the urethra. Through urethra and the urinary bladder in muscular, and it is under the control of nervous system. So the right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney, and each kidney has approximately 10 lakh nephrons, the approximately 5 liter of blood which is present in the normal body. Person's body is filtered by the kidneys about 400 times every day. Thus, every day, the kidneys filter about 190 liters of blood, from which about 1 to 1.9 liters of urine is formed, and the remaining liquid is again reabsorbed. Now, we have also learned about dialysis deficiency. If the deficiency of kidneys can be adversely affected by injury, infection, or decreased blood supply, so what will happen? So an excess of toxic substances get accumulated inside the body. So we need, or we can lead to that also. If kidneys fail, nitrogenous waste are separated from the blood with the help of the man-made machine, which is called as dialyzer. About 500 milliliter of blood is sent at one time through the machine. Now we have learned about the coordination also. In that, we have learned about the coordination in plants, how plants coordinate with each other. Now, nervous control, human nervous control, in that we have learned about the neurons also. So the types of cell or neurons are there. There are three types of neurons which are classified according to the function. So sensory neuron, motor neuron, association neuron. Sensory neuron means it conducts impulses from the sensory organs to the brain and the spinal cord. Motor neurons conduct impulses from the brain or spinal cord to effector organs like muscle or glands. Now the association neurons perform the function of integration in the nervous system. The human nervous system consists of three parts. PNS means central nervous system, PNS means peripheral nervous system, and autonomous system is ANS. In central nervous system, it consists of brain and spinal cord. The organization of the brain is extremely delicate and highly evolved. The brain is the main controlling part of the nervous system, and is safely located in the cranial cavity. The spinal cord is protected by vertebral column also. In the space between the delicate central nervous system and its bony covering are the protective layering called as meninges. It is called as meninges. Cavities present in various parts of the brain are called ventricles, whereas the long tubular cavity of spinal cord is called the central canal. The ventricles, central canal, and spaces between the meninges are filled with cerebrospinal fluid. This fluid supplies nutrients to the central nervous system and protects it from the shock. Now, the brain of an adult weighs about 1300 to 1400 grams and consists of approximately 100 billion neurons. The left side of our brain controls the right side of our brain, and right side of the brain controls by the left side of the brain. So, in addition, the left side of the brain controls our speech and conversation, writing, logical thinking, etc. Whereas the right side controls artistic variation. We have learned about the left side brain and right side brain also. Function of left side brain, analytical thinking, logical thinking, languages, sense, and mathematics. The function of right brain is holistic thinking, intuition, creativity, art, and music. Then we have learned about cerebrum also. Cerebrum is the largest part of our brain and consists of two cerebral hemispheres. These hemispheres are joined with each other with the help of tough fibers and nerve tracts. These the cerebrum occupies 2/3 of the brain, hence it is called as nerve large brain. The surface has deep irregular ridges and grooves, which are called convolutions, and these convolutions increase the surface area of the cerebrum, and therefore a large number of nerves can be accommodated. Now, cerebrum, this is the smaller part of the brain situated below the cerebrum at the back of the cranial cavity, and its surface shows shallow grooves instead of deep convolutions. Medulla oblongata, this is the hindmost part of the brain. There are two triangular swallow structures called pyramids on the upper side of the medulla oblongata. The medulla oblongata consists of downwards as the spinal cord. Now, the spinal cord is the part of central nervous system, and it's held within the vertebral column. It is slightly thick but gradually tapers towards the end. There is a thread-like structure at its end called the phylum terminus. Now, the function of the cerebrum is its control of voluntary movement, central concentration, planning, decision-making, memory, intelligence, and intellectual activities. Then cerebrum, coordination of involuntary movements, maintaining the body's balance. Now, medulla oblongata, control of involuntary activities like the beating of the heart, blood circulation, breathing, sneezing, coughing, and salivation. Then, spinal cord, conduction of impulse from the skin towards the brain, conduction of impulse from brain to muscles and glands, functions as center of coordination of reflex action. So you can see the largest part in this picture is cerebrum, and the linear part are called cerebrum, and the other part of the pyramid are called as brainstem or medulla oblongata. Now the evaluation questions are there, so you need to draw well-labeled diagram of human brain. In that you need to show that how human brain is, like it consists of a cerebrum, cerebellum, and medulla oblongata. Write a short note on brain, means in that you need to write how much it weighs, means 1300 to 1400 grams. It consists of approximately 100 to billion neurons. And the picture is shown, you need to label it. The largest portion is called a cerebrum, and the portion which have the parallel lines are the is the cerebellum, and the other part which is elongated till spinal cord is called as medulla oblongata. So you need to draw these things. So here we are going to stop, because we have done with today's session. Thank you so much. If you have any queries, you can ask. Thank you. हेलो 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 मैम, on the next the session was our last session, fifth session. In that we are going to learn about peripheral nervous system and autonomic nervous system. So brain is the most important part, which have three type of nerve cells. You can also draw a nerve cell or structure of neuron. It is given yesterday only, maybe na, for the evaluation. Okay. So this is in today you need to draw the well level diagram only of human brain. It come in examination also for 2 to 5 marks. It depends. If explanation is asked, then it is for 5 marks. So only labeling and diagram is there, so it is for 2 marks maybe. So in that you need to draw well and level diagram. Convolutions you need to show, because convolutions are very much important, which increases the surface area of the brain. It increases the surface area of the brain. We need to draw that. This also, we have learned about two types of brains, type of brain, like left side and right side. Right side controls the left side portion, and left side brain controls the right side. The person, if anybody is good in logical thinking, realistic languages, science and mathematics, it means that their left brain works very nice. If anybody is good in art and creativity, poetry, senses, emotional part, feeling filled, so that person's right portion is very much active in that specific part. So it works like this only. So you need to know all these things also. Our body fully depends on this nervous system only. You need to understood the diagram of spinal cord, how it is. Spinal cord is very much important. If it will get a break, then we will not able to walk properly, or we will not able to stand properly. So due to that, we need to take care of all this. So brain is a very much delicate, which is held inside the cranial cavity, protects our skeletal system, protects the brain, which is there inside the skull. Our skull is there, so in that inside there it is safe. So whenever you can see that whenever any accident happens on the road, what will happen? We need to wear helmet. Why we need to wear the helmet? Why? Because it will not get, our skull will not get hurt, and due to that skull, our inside brain will not get hurt or will not get affected by this. So we need to wear helmet on riding, right? It is very much important part in our life. We need to follow all the rules and regulations what are given by our society. Society in the sense given by our constitution. Okay. So we'll stop here. We have already revised it for more lots of time. So we'll stop. Hello. Hello. Hello, ma'am. Hello. Hello, ma'am. Hello. Hello. Okay, we'll wait a few minutes. Thank you. हेलो हेलो मैम, प्रजापति मैम, सॉरी प्राजक्ता मैम, हेलो 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 मैम, इट्स डन,
भगवान भाई का।